Dear students, today we are going to discuss the topic Auxins, History of Discovery, Biosynthesis and their role in plant growth and development. Our objectives are to know about the history of discovery of auxins, to understand the process of auxin biosynthesis, to let you know about the role of auxins in plant growth and development, to give a brief idea about the uses of synthetic auxins as plant growth regulators. Growth and development in higher plants are regulated by chemical signals. These chemical messengers, called as hormones, are often synthesized in one part and transported to other part where they produce their effects. They have dramatic effects on plant growth and development at vanishingly small concentrations. Plant hormones, also known as plant growth regulators, include auxins, cytokinins, gibberellins, ethylene and abscisic acid. In addition to that, there is now ample evidence available for the role of brassinosteroids, salicylic acid and jasmonic acid as plant growth regulators. Among all plant growth regulators, auxin was the first growth regulator to be discovered. The role of auxins in plant growth is so important that the mutants lacking auxin are not viable. The term auxin has been derived from the Greek word auxin, that means to increase or to grow. Compounds that induce cell elongation in coleoptiles and stem sections or resemble indole-3 acetic acid IAA in their physiological activities are considered as auxins. Auxins affect many physiological and developmental processes in plants in addition to elongation of cells in stem, but this characteristic is considered critical of all auxins and thus helps define the hormone. Discovery of auxins. Charles Darwin was among the first scientists to get involved in plant hormone research. Charles Darwin and his son Francis studied bending of the coleoptiles towards the unilateral source of light, a phenomenon known as phototropism. Bending of coleoptiles during phototropism is mediated by more growth on the shaded side compared to the illuminated side that leads to bending of the stem towards light. Charles Darwin, in his book The Power of Moments in Plants, describes the effect of light on movement of canary grass Phalaris canariensis coleoptiles. When unilateral light shines on the coleoptile, it bends in the direction of light. If the tip of the coleoptile was covered with aluminium foil, no bending would occur towards the unilateral light. However, if the tip of the coleoptile was left uncovered, but the portion just below the tip was covered, exposure to unidirectional light resulted in curvature towards the light. Darwin then cut off the tip of the coleoptile and exposed the rest of the coleoptile to unidirectional light. Curvature did not occur. Confirming that the tip of the coleoptile was the tissue responsible for perceiving the light and it produced some signal which was transported to the lower part of the coleoptile where the physiological response of bending occurred. The region of the coleoptile where bending occurs is called growth zone and it occurs several millimeters below the tip. Finally, in 1926, Fritz Wendt demonstrated the presence of growth promoting factor in tip of oat Avena stiva. He demonstrated it by placing excised coleoptile tips on gelatin blocks. The growth promoting factor diffused out of the tips directly into gelatin blocks. When these blocks were placed asymmetrically on decapitated Avena stems, the stems could bend in absence of unilateral light. Later, Wendt developed a bioassay for quantitative analysis of this plant growth substance. His results suggested that the curvature of stem was proportional to the amount of growth substance in the block. This test was called the Avena curvature test. In 1935, Kogel isolated auxin triolic acid from the urine of a Dutch patient and named it as auxin A. Subsequently, he also isolated indole-3 acetic acid IAA, the principal auxin of in plants from human urine. Auxins and auxin analogues. Structurally, auxins are a diverse group of compounds with at least an aromatic ring and a carboxylic acid group. A common feature of all active auxins is a molecular distance of 0.5 nanometer between a fractional positive charge on the aromatic ring and a negative charge on the carbonyl group. The majority of auxin effects in intact plants are mediated by IAA, and it is the most potent native auxin in plants. However, molecules of IAA are chemically labile in aqueous solution, so it is not used commercially as a plant growth regulator. IAA is found in all plants, but other related compounds with auxin activity have also been identified from plants. For example, 4-chloroindole-3 acetic acid is present in peas, whereas indole-3 butyric acid IBA is present in mustard and corn. All these auxins are classified as natural auxins. Natural auxins include indole-3 acetic acid IAA, indole-3 butyric acid IBA, 4-chloroindole-3 acetic acid, 2-phenyl acetic acid PAA. A number of molecules have been synthesized by many laboratories that are not found in plants but have physiological activities similar to natural auxin IAA. These compounds are referred to as synthetic auxins. Most of these synthetic auxins are used as herbicides or defoliants in agriculture and horticulture. Synthetic auxins include 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid 2,4-D, 2,4,5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid 2,4,5-T, alpha-naphthalene acetic acid alpha-NAA, 2-methoxy-3,6-dichlorobenzoic acid Dicamba, 4-amino-3,5,6-trichloropecalonic acid or peclorame, auxin biosynthesis. The enzymes responsible for the synthesis of IAA are most active in young tissues such as shoot apical meristems, young leaves, and immature fruits. The highest concentration of IAA are found in these tissues. Chemically, IAA is similar to amino acid tryptophan, which is regarded to be the possible precursor of IAA. Available evidence suggests following possible mechanism by which plants convert tryptophan into IAA. The indole-3 pyruvic acid pathway, IPA pathway, the tryptamine pathway, TAM pathway, the indole-3 acetonitrile pathway, IAN pathway. In IPA pathway, tryptophan is converted to indole-3 pyruvic acid through a deamination reaction. Indole-3 pyruvic acid so formed is converted to indole-3 acetaldehyde by decarboxylation reaction. In the final step, indole-3 acetaldehyde is oxidized to IAA. In TAM pathway, the order of transamination and decarboxylation is reversed. Tryptophan first undergoes decarboxylation to form tryptamine. Tryptamine is then oxidized and deaminated to produce indole-3 acetaldehyde, which is oxidized further to produce IAA. In indole-3 acetonitrile pathway, tryptophan is first converted to indole-3 acetaldoxime, which is converted to indole-3 acetonitrile IAN. Indole-3 acetamide is finally converted to IAA by the enzyme nitrilase. Plants are also known to synthesize IAA via a tryptophan independent mechanism. Role of auxin. Auxins are defined by their ability to induce elongation in coleoptiles and stem sections. Auxins affect almost every aspect of plant growth and development. They modulate diverse processes such as tropic response to light and gravity, apical dominance, stem elongation, root initiation, fruit development, abscission, vascular development, and growth in tissue culture. Synthetic auxins are used as herbicides to induce parthenocarpy, prevent premature fruit drop, and initiate adventitious rooting in stem cuttings. Auxins stimulate cell elongation. The zone of cell elongation in plants is a few millimeters below the apical region. A steady supply of auxin is important to maintain elongation of cells in this zone. Auxin causes a 5- to 10-fold increase in the growth rate, mainly by increasing the extensibility of the cell wall. Wall loosening is explained by well-accepted acid growth hypothesis. According to this hypothesis, auxin increases the rate of proton extrusion from the cytoplasm into the cell wall, resulting in acidification of the cell wall. At acidic pH, the wall loosening proteins called expansins loosen the cell wall by weakening the hydrogen bonds between the polysaccharide components of the cell wall. The overall cell enlargement takes place in three steps. Cell absorbs water through osmosis. Water absorption results in the development of the turgor pressure because of the rigidity of the cell wall. Biochemical loosening of the cell wall by expansins allows the cell to expand in response to turgor pressure. Tropic moments. Plants orient themselves with respect to light and gravity. The growth moment of plants in response to light is called phototropism, and the growth moment of plants in response to gravity is called gravitropism. These growth moments, tropisms in plants, are mediated by lateral redistribution of auxin. Auxin is transported bicipitally, that is, it moves from the apex to base. In polar transport, auxin enters the cell from any side but leaves the cell through the plasma membrane. Auxin efflux carriers, also known as pin proteins, preferably localized at the basal end of the cell. Auxin is also transported laterally in plants. In lateral transport, the pin proteins are redistributed to the lateral side of the cell, allowing auxin to move laterally. This lateral unequal distribution induces differential growth, resulting in bending of plant parts in response to light and gravity. Phototropism. Shoots exhibit positive phototropism, that is, when illuminated from one direction, the shoots bend and grow in the direction of light. Mechanism. Auxin produced in the tip normally moves bicipitally from the apical region to the zone of elongation. When a shoot is illuminated with a unilateral source of light, auxin efflux transporters, also known as pin proteins, in the plasma membrane are redistributed to the lateral face of cells of the shoot. Auxin is pumped out laterally by pin proteins and accumulates more in the cells on the shaded side of the coleoptile. Auxin on shaded side is then transported bicipitally to the zone of cell elongation. This stimulates faster elongation of the cells on the shaded side as compared to the cells on the illuminated side, and as a result, the shoot bends towards the light. Gravitropism. Gravitropism is a plant growth response to gravity. Roots display positive gravitropism, that is, they grow in the direction of gravity, while as shoots show negative gravitropism, that is, they grow away from gravity. Mechanism. Auxin synthesized in the shoot is transported to the root through steel. When a root is placed horizontally on its side, statoliths, also called as amyloplasts, that function as gravity sensors, settle to the side of the cells in the root cap due to gravity. This causes pin proteins to redistribute to the lower side towards the ground of the cells, and as a result, auxin is transported to the lower side of the root. This inhibits root cell elongation on the lower side and stimulates upper side to grow faster, causing the root to grow down. Vascular differentiation. The differentiation of new vascular tissue is controlled by the auxin produced by the young leaves and growing buds. The regeneration of the vascular tissue in the wound tissue is also stimulated by the auxin produced by the young leaf just above the wound. At higher concentrations, auxin stimulates the formation of both xylem and phloem, but xylem differentiation is more favored, whereas low auxin concentrations favor phloem differentiation. Apical dominance. Growing apical bud inhibits the growth of lateral or axillary buds in most of the higher plants. This phenomenon, known as apical dominance, is mediated by auxin. Removal of apical bud in Physiolus vulgaris was found to release the axillary buds from apical dominance. Application of auxin in lanolin paste to the cut surface of the decapitated stem could prevent the growth of axillary buds, confirming that the growth of axillary buds is inhibited by auxin that is produced in the apical bud and transported basipetally to the lateral buds. Gardeners usually prune the terminal shoot of ornamental plants. It releases lateral buds from apical dominance and stimulates growth in them. Fruit development. Pollination of flowers in angiosperms initiates the formation of seeds. The pollen and the endosperm and embryo of a developing seed produce auxin. As the seeds mature, they release auxin to the surrounding flower parts, which may serve as an initial stimulus for fruit growth. The endosperm may act as main source of auxin during initial stages of fruit growth and the developing embryo during the later stages. Commercial growers apply auxin to the flowers in order to initiate fruit development. Not only does this ensure that all flowers will set fruit, but it also maximizes the likelihood that all the fruits will be ready for harvest at the same time. Parthenocarpy. Parthenocarpy is the formation of seedless fruit without fertilization. Exogenous application of auxin is known to induce formation of seedless fruits in a number of plants such as tomato, apple, cucumber, etc. Abscission. In plants, mature leaves and ripe fruits fall off from the plant by a process known as abscission. These parts abscise by the formation of abscission layer in the abscission zone, which is located at the base of petiole or fruit stalk. Auxins play an important role in regulating the process of abscission. Young leaves and fruits have high auxin levels, and as long as they do so, they remain attached to the stem. When the level of auxin declines, a special layer of cells called the abscission layer forms at the base of the petiole or fruit stalk. The cell walls of the cells in the abscission layer are digested, which makes them soft and weak. Soon the petiole or fruit stalk breaks free at this point and the leaf or fruit falls to the ground. Fruit growers often apply auxin spray to cut down the loss of fruit from premature dropping. Root initiation and development. Auxin at low concentrations from 10^-7 to 10^-13 molar promotes root growth, but at higher concentrations it inhibits the elongation of the primary root. However, auxin at higher concentrations promotes initiation of lateral and adventitious roots. Lateral roots originate from the cells in the pericycle. Auxin stimulates the division of patches of cells in the pericycle that develop into a root apex. This root apex grows through the cortex and the epidermis and elongates to form a lateral root. Adventitious roots grow from stem, branches, or leaves rather than from the regular root stem that arises from the radicle of the embryo. Auxins stimulate adventitious root formation in stem cuttings and leaves. Auxin to cytokinin ratio is important for morphogenesis in tissue culture. Higher auxin to cytokinin ratio favors root formation, whereas lower auxin to cytokinin ratio favors shoot formation. Uses of synthetic auxins. In addition to natural auxins, exogenous application of many compounds synthesized artificially with biological activities similar to IAA have been useful in regulating many aspects of plant growth. application of synthetic auxins induces formation of seedless fruits without fertilization, a process known as parthenocarpy, in many plants like apple, tomato and cucumber. These parthenocarpic fruits have a great demand in the market. Application of auxin promotes fruit set, synchronizes fruit maturation and prevents premature fruit fall. Some synthetic auxins like 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid 2,4-D and 2,4-5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acid 2,4-5-T are widely used as herbicides because they specifically kill only broad-leaved plants. Monocots can inactivate synthetic auxins by conjugation. That is why synthetic auxins are commercially used to kill dicot weeds in cereal fields. Agent Orange, a mixture of 2,4-D and 2,4-5-T, was used by US military to defoliate the forests in parts of South Vietnam. Auxin achieves its many different effects in the plant by two ways. Direct activation of proton pumps. Auxin affects gene expression. Direct activation of proton pumps. Auxin binds to a cell surface auxin binding protein ABP1 receptor. Binding of the auxin to the receptor directly activates proton ATPases and increases the rate of proton extrusion. Second messengers such as calcium may be involved in this process. Auxin affects gene expression. Many auxin effects are mediated by change in the gene expression. Auxin enters the nucleus and binds to transport inhibitor response receptor TIR1 that in turn binds to protein that mediate binding of AuxIAA protein to ubiquitin. This triggers the destruction of the AuxIAA protein in proteasome. The AuxIAA protein normally bind auxin response factors ARF, preventing them from activating the control sequence of genes that are turned on or off by auxin. Destruction of the AuxIAA proteins relieves ARF transcription factor from this inhibition and gene transcription begins. Students, I hope that you have understood the role of auxin in plant growth and development and how auxin is synthesized in plants and what is the role or application of synthetic auxins in agriculture. Thank you.